Welcome to Excel Magic Trick 1875. And we have a great question from Manuel from Cuba. We have this data set with a unique identifier, 1, 2, 3. That means 1, 2, 3 rows should really be a single record in a proper data set. These are the field names, and this is the data. So we need to go from this table into a proper data set. Now, just a few videos ago in Short 61, we had a similar situation. The records were in a column. But here, we didn't have that identifier, and we didn't have field names. So we just typed them out. And the easiest way is to use wrap rows. This is an example where dynamic spilled array functions almost seem easier than Power Query. But check this situation out. We do need these to be in a unique list with an ID column. These are the field names, and these are the records. In this case, the Power Query pivot column feature is actually easier because it'll repeat the field names, including this one listing a unique list, and repeat 1, 2, 3 data points in a single row as a record. Now, when you use pivot column, that means we have three items, three data bits in a column, and we need it as a record. When you use UnPivot, the data is actually not in a column, it's in a row. And you need to repeat that into a column, and then take the single item for the row and repeat it in each row. So this is different than UnPivot. But man, is it easy. Click in a single cell, and instead of going to data, getting transformed, that button right there. I like keyboards. You got to find the right click key right to the left of the control key. And when I hit it, it pops up a menu. All of the underlined letters mean if we hit that letter, it invokes that. And you got to be kidding me. Get data from table range. So escape, it's really just right click G. And I use that all the time because it's faster than going up to the data ribbon tab, getting transformed. Here's the steps. I don't need change type, so I'm going to exit out. And all we have to do is select the field with the column or field names, go up to transform. There it is, any column group, pivot column. We need to say, hey, the data is in the data, or the values are in the data column. And I don't want to aggregate. I want to let all of the elements flow across the different columns. Don't aggregate. So I click Don't Aggregate, click OK. And that is simply amazing. Now I want to click on the last column, hold Shift, click on the first column, transform, detect data types. It didn't get that one right because this is a credit card. It has leading zeros, so I'm going to say text. I mean, the data type is text. Replace that right there. And there we go, leading zeros. Now let's remove the spaces from the applied steps identifier names. Backspace, Enter. I hit the F2 key to quickly put it in edit mode, backspace. Actually, I like to always name this step Add Data Types. If you buy the book that I just wrote about M-code, you'll see every single step that adds data types. That's what it's named. Now if we go up to Home, Query, Advanced Editor, there's our lovely code. Source, excel.currentworkbook, an amazing function that pulls tables in from the current workbook. Pivot column, there it is. And look at that. It was polite. It used list.distinct on the column we selected. And then add data types in. That's what's delivered. Done. Now we can close and load. Close and load too. I'm going to keep it as a table existing. Try and put it in G18, click OK. And that's pretty amazing. Simply pivot this column, and bam, into a proper data set. Now, if you like this video and you like Power Query, I wrote a whole book about the M-code functional language in Power Query. It's available at Amazon. Go check it out, and we'll see you next Excel Magic Trick.